two gray boxes.
Ooh, precious coral.
And precious coral. Cool, let's jump in.
Precious coral. I think it's gonna be like a reddish orange, maybe some pink. It could be cut into cabochons, beads, carved figurines. Could be just like a, you know, a specimen. So coral is an organic, which means at one point it came from something that may have been living, unlike a sapphire, which has no tie to anything living at all. Okay, but I don't wanna wait, cause I wanna see what's in this. Yay! Oh, that's so pretty. Okay, so we've got a cameo right here. You can see, I think we've mentioned cameos in the past. This, the face is kind of raised, and then this, wow, it's so pretty, look at that. I love this color. It's like kind of an orangey reddish. I mean, that's a coral color, isn't that beautiful? I don't know, I actually own some cameos. They're shell, and I know my grandfather brought them back from Europe right after World War II. So I know they've been doing them that long. I don't know the time frame of these though. Yeah. Oh, cool. I love these. I love this. Okay, so right here we have like branches of coral. You know, I'm just gonna take these out of the box, gently. Okay, so these are really smooth, great color. These are a little bit more orange than this one. You know, you can kind of see the variance of color. These look like branches, and it's kind of cool. You can see some like lines on here. It looks like, you know, it doesn't look like just a, you know, smooth piece of plastic. There's, you know, lines that you can see. It's really cool. This is like a rough piece. This is how you find them. It looks to me like this particular piece, these pieces have been polished because they're very smooth. Don't they? They do look like little pretzel sticks. I would actually make jewelry out of something like this. If you look at like a piece like this, I mean, that would be really cool. Get a chain right here in the end. And you know, like that, just a piece of like, you know, a bar of this. I've seen some really cool bar necklaces like that. Maybe a smaller piece like this one as an earring or something. These you could do a whole lot of. If you had a room in your house that was kind of like a maritime theme, you know, having some coral would be really cool. You could easily display this on a cabinet or something. These to me feel really fragile. I mean, I think if I wanted to, I could easily snap one of these two in half. And I'm not going to because coral is valuable and I don't own this and I would never do that to something this beautiful. Coral is not something that you would ever put in an engagement ring. You would probably not put it in a piece of jewelry that you're gonna wear every day because it is a little bit more delicate. But should I just put this on? I think it does match my outfit, doesn't it? Oh my gosh, what a coincidence. Coral is actually one of my favorite gemstones. I have some coral beads that I'm hoping to make a bracelet out of. So this is kind of fitting for what I'm doing in my outside of work. I'm working with coral. What's super cool about coral, and one of the reasons I love it the most, is that it's actually an organic. Okay, so what does that mean? Organic means that it once was part of like a living animal. You know, obviously now this is not living. Those animals and this material, because it's organic, there are a lot of agencies that protect coral and make sure that any coral that we have in the jewelry and gem industry is ethically sourced and it's environmentally friendly. The coral that you see in reefs, you know, those beautiful colors, none of that is used in the jewelry and gem business. You know, no one would go and just pluck something off of a coral reef. A lot of the coral is actually harvested with dredging. So they, you know, go into the ocean and they sweep up whatever they can get that is not on a reef. What's awesome about coral is that it's literally found all over the world. From the equators to the poles, you can find some type of coral. Not all of it may be used in jewelry, but all of it is interesting and you can learn something from it. You see that, you know, that kind of like orangish red color? That actually comes from carotenoids. And carotenoids are basically the same thing that you find in carrots. It's what gives it that red, orangey, really bright color. So the word coral actually comes from the Greek word carillion, I don't know exactly what it is. I don't speak Greek. But that word is thought to have referred more to the coral that's coming from the Mediterranean. So the history of coral, you know, there's a lot of gemstones in the business and they have some pretty significant histories, and coral is one of them. Back in the 1500s to 1700s, a lot of famous painters would actually paint a red bracelet on children because it was thought to protect them.
And there are other ancient beliefs that if you were wearing a piece of coral against your skin and it lost its color, it was protecting you from the potential threat of a severe illness or even a deadly poison. This just goes back and shows you how important and how much of a history humans have had with coral, and how it's not just a piece of jewelry, but it really is, you know, has a cultural significance as well. You know, there's a lot of gemstones, and they have, you know, they're important for a variety of reasons. Maybe it's where they come from, or they're, you know, not found often, or they've got a really vibrant color, maybe like lapis. But coral, I think, is also valuable not only because of the color and that it is an organic, but also because of its cultural significance. Most of the coral I've seen is actually cut into beads. So I've just seen strands and strands of beads. And it's when you go to trade shows, there's just these walls and they've got, you know, all these different shades of red, and there's pink, and I've even seen some white coral. Mostly what I'm familiar with is strands of beads and coral, but I've also seen coral, you know, displayed in people's homes. And I've seen a significant amount of rough coral. Although I would say this is polished because it, you know, rough coral is very dull. I don't know if I would call this rough. There's such a variety of things that you can do with coral. You know, it doesn't just have to be in jewelry. I've seen quite a few pieces carved like this, and that's a really unique, beautiful piece. So these branch-like structures are pretty typical. These to me look a little bit smaller though. When I looked at this piece, I can tell, to me, it seems like it's one solid piece of coral, which is amazing because look how big that is, but look how small some of these are. So, you know, that's just really fascinating to look at what is possible with coral. I also like how this piece, you can see some like color banding, which we can get a closer look on later. There's so many ways that you can use it. It's a great addition to any jewelry and gemstone collection. I personally have some coral. They're little beads, a little bit more darker red than this, but they're absolutely gorgeous. All right, so another really cool thing about coral is that it is made of calcium carbonate. But why is that cool? Because that's the same thing that pearl is actually made out of. So we've got two organics, but they've got one thing in common, and that is you know, some of their building blocks. Although it kind of blows my mind because coral is this red and pearl is usually not this vibrant. Something you have to be careful of with coral is its spot on Mohs scale. So it's only like 3 to 4, which means this is probably not gonna be a ring that you wear every single day. I think it's best suited in pendants, earring, necklaces, and that's mostly what I've seen it carved as. I don't think I've ever seen a coral ring, but I'm sure it exists. People do whatever they can with beautiful pieces like this. Take a closer look at the banding on this cameo. You can see a little bit right there on the bottom, but the best view is on the back of the piece right there. Do you see that? I absolutely love that. Okay, second thing I want you to take a closer look at is the branch-like structure on these pieces of coral that haven't been carved. They look to me like they've just been polished or tumbled or something. This is definitely something that you wouldn't see in a lab. If I had to guess what it'd be like to bite into these, I think it'd feel like a Cheeto or like a pretzel or something. Not that I ever want to eat coral, but because we always talk about food here on the unboxing. Glad you learned about coral today. I certainly am. I loved learning about the color banding here on the back of this cameo. I think it's really pretty. So what's so cool about coral is that there are so many people who value it, you know, to wear, value its cultural significance, but there are also so many people who, you know, want to protect the stone, see the value of having an ethically sourced and environmentally friendly market, because that's our obligation to the business, protect the resources that we're given. I'm really glad this coral made a cameo on your screen today. You probably want to learn more about gemstones, which means you should probably subscribe and like our channel so you don't miss out on what we've got coming up next. I can assure you that there will be more beautiful, bright colors, cool facts, and maybe a few bad jokes.